Happy Thumbs Gaming. Big show.
Hey everybody, it's Brian with Happy Thumbs Gaming, and we're back with some more LEGO Harry Potter years 5 through 7. In fact, we are starting the final section of the game. That's right. Technically, it's not year 8, but it's kind of like year 8, but it's like 7.5. But we're going to go ahead and kick it off with level 19, the Thief's Downfall free play. We're going to shoot for that true wizard requirement of 100k, which should be easy peasy with our red brick multipleasies. And yeah, that's right. We've got some red brick multipliers on, helping us get to that high total. And look at this, we're in the final bottom right section, so the final 6 levels. That's right, we're gonna go ahead and tee it off, the Thief's Downfall. Now, somebody brought it to my attention that the reason why Remus Lupin, our strong character of choice, was not popping up by default is because he's technically not a strong character. He's actually a regular person that has a alternate ability. So I guess that makes sense. Like, if that's not true, that's the closest theory on why that makes sense. And here we are, we're off and rolling on this roller coaster. And you might remember, there's a lot of spamming of the spell button going on here. We need to cast a bunch of spells, and I'm just zing, 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 zing. And I actually get hosed right there. You notice I hit the target, but it didn't change green. Not sure what that's all about, but I do have to make a secondary lap because of it. So I failed this and missed one on my story attempt, and now here we are. I was ready in my free play. I knew this was a problem, and I knew how to get by it, but for some reason I got hosed. But on the second round, I get it, and boy, this is a pretty cool, agile device here. This roller coaster is going up and around and all over, and we're going to take a right real quick and go under a waterfall, but we've removed that cutscene and gone straight to the dragon. Speaking of dragon, we're going to actually start off by going to the left-hand side of him. And you might notice there is these silver rocks. In fact, there are four of them scattered throughout. In fact, there are 3 of them on the far right side and then that one we just zapped on the left. And here we go. You can see all 3 of them are just out in the open right here. But when we came here in story, I'm not sure. We probably had it. I'm not sure we did, but I'm pretty sure we did. You know, we had it, and then we lost it, and then we got it back, so it could go either way. But look at that, we got the old Gryffindor red house crest piece, just for simply removing all 4 of those silver blocks. And next up, we're going to switch to our character with dark magic abilities, and we're going to go ahead and manipulate this red and black object, which looks like some sort of a train track light, you know, like a red light, green light kind of a thing. Red light, green light. And once we actually cue that up, it's actually going to make this roller coaster roll on down. Watch out, that next step's a doozy. And what happens is it brings us some goods. And we're going to use Leviosa to put up a climbing wall and remove a Weasley box from the train tracks. And then once we've got it on the ground, we're going to go ahead and use our favorite Weasley to access it, get some of those sticky shoes, and run up the side there. So, oh yeah, we've got a character token and a house crest piece already under our belt. But I will let you know that there is a little bit of a break between now and the next collectible. So if you are here simply for the collectibles, feel free to use our quick links down below in the video description. The next one's going to actually be the student in peril, which is roughly the 4:39 mark. But we're going to go ahead and complete this. We're also going to pay attention to this orange handle, the strong handle on the left. Now, in order to get past this level or this part of the level, you need to use Leviosa to smash that hammer and ring that bell, which drops a key for us, which we can use over on the right-hand side. But we're going to go ahead and switch to a strong character right quick and actually rip open this box. Now, I probably should have waited, as this has something to do with a collectible that we cannot access yet. We have to go and shut some things down. We have to remove that fire path is what we really need to do. But we've got the Quibbler dispenser out, and we'll make note of that for later. We'll go ahead and grab that key for now, and we'll go ahead and slam it in the side of this. It's weird. It's like a cow, but it's not. It's like a cowmobile? I'm not sure. But we'll go ahead and put this key on, wind it up, and get our murr on here in a second. And watch out, it is kind of a funny angle putting that key in. As you might remember in my story playthrough, I got knocked off the edge trying to spin that crank around. So look at that, we've rode on over. The cow kind of does his own thing here. We don't have to do much of anything other than drive him to the circle. And then he goes, murr! And look at that, we've got kind of a free path inside the doorway here, which is key to advancing through this level. Now, as soon as we start in this room here, this happens to be some sort of a trophy room or vault. We're going to go ahead and use magic, dark magic that is, on the right-hand side to go ahead and shake up the cage and free that student in peril. That's right, we've already turned that frown upside down. Next up, we're going to use more dark magic on another black and red object just beyond the cage. And look at that. We're going to manipulate this poster up on the wall and grab that character token. So look at this. If you blink, you're going to miss some stuff. It happens rather fast. Next up, we're actually going to get that blue or Ravenclaw house crest piece. And we're going to need, what do we need? We need a strong character. Ow! And we're going to go ahead and switch on over to werewolf mode and rip open this strong handle here, which actually pukes out a handful of bricks. So it looks like the theme to this level is the Quibbler. And if you haven't already gotten the trophy achievement for using the Quibbler dispenser 25 times, I would imagine you're going to get it in this level. Now, look at that. I've ripped it open, and instead of getting a newspaper, I've actually got some 3D goggles, or the Spectre Specs, and I'm going to go ahead to the back of the right area, or the right corner of the room, and look at that. I've actually found some bricks that I can manipulate into this weird head here. And we're going to go ahead and target him and give him the old pow right in the kissa. And look at that. He dances around, and I don't know if he burps out that or what happened, but we'll go ahead and take it. Thank you very much. Next up, more dark magic on the left-hand side. Not really original as far as the requirements or objectives here. It's all kind of rinse and repeat type of things here. But we'll go ahead and manipulate that black and red claw. I don't know what it is, but we got a gold head out of it. We'll bring that head down, slap it on the old post here, watch them dance around, and look at that. Booyaka show! We got the old Hermione Gringotts character token, so moving right along. In fact, what do we got? We got one more item here. It's another dark magic item, so if you don't have dark magic, you're not going to get very far on this level. Hopefully you followed our preparing for free play video, or maybe you have the Harry Potter collection on PS4, which gives you some characters at the start, one of them being Salazar Slytherin, I believe, and he is a dark magic character. We keep seeing him pop up in our arsenal. I don't remember ever unlocking him, or certainly haven't purchased him, so he must be an added character that comes with the collection. So, all right, on to the story-based stuff. You probably noticed that there was a little note there to use the quick links down below in the video description. If you're here wondering how to beat this level, we're going to go ahead and use the old bag of tricks pad in the back, or the pink base plate, and once we get that open, we actually find some pieces that we build into a bee. The bee lands up on the head there, which then drops a feather, and then we tickle the feather, and we get some more bricks, and all of a sudden we're way over here. And yeah, I'm kind of behind, but you saw it. You saw it all. And if you didn't, you could always rewind and watch it again. But yeah, so we've got some pieces on the left for the right. And we're just going to use Leviosa over here to go ahead and drop these swords down and spin to win. And actually, it gives us some bricks that we're going to build into a parcel tongue puzzle. So we'll go ahead and switch to a character fluent in parcel tongue. And I tried to cheat here. I tried to use Lumos on that devil snare there, but it did not work. I actually have to use the old deluminator lamp, which is coming up soon. So solve this old parcel tongue puzzle, and this crazy hand comes out of the wall and says, here you go. And we're gonna go ahead and swoop that up real quick. And look at this. We've got what we needed, and it's got this weird spell going on in here where anything we touch multiplies. So you got to be careful on how many things you touch. I'm not sure that you can ever get stuck or anything can go wrong here, but it could get a little problematic, I'm sure. Now, there are two trophies, one sitting on the little ledge there that when we first walked into the room we saw, and the second one was actually found through the parcel tongue puzzle, and the one we need, in fact, I think we need to actually have access to both of them before we can get access to this little safer locker key. I'm not sure what we want to call this, but we do need a key character in order to lower the old deluminator lamp, which comes in quite handy because I just mentioned we're going to need that. And over on the right-hand side, we'll go ahead and take it, and booyakashow! Now we need to use the key character again to lift up the lamp. So you had to use the key character once to lower it, now you gotta use it again to raise it. So raise the roof with that light and get rid of them tentacly-like things. That's right, and there's the trophy we actually need, but truthfully, we just need to go up there and use the pink base plate. So switch back to Hermione, hop on the old bag of tricks pad, and let's see what you got, what you got, what you got! After a successful pull of the sword, it actually takes us away and drops us right back out where this dragon was, except for this time there's not that fire trail blocking our path to the right-hand side of the area. So, hey, if you have not already used a strong character to rip open this strong handle here, do so now and build the pieces you find up into the Quibbler dispenser and grab your Spectre Specs, or 3D goggles as I like to call them, and make your way to the back right corner of the area, which you'll find the pink and green glowy bits, kind of wild style essence. I guess that's kind of, it's what it reminds me of, if you think about it. The old scan bits from Dimensions, kind of same thing, but different, you know. And look at that. We have got a handle, and we put it on, and we spun it around, and look at that. Booyaka show! We've got all four of the House Crest pieces making the actual House Crest. And, yeah, we've actually got all of the character tokens, and we turn that frown upside down, too. So, officially, you are done with all the collectibles, and one could hit the old options or start button and choose return to Diagon Alley. Or no, it's Leaky Cauldron, isn't it? Which one is it? It's one of the two. Return to one of the two. And, of course, you want to use the save and exit option on the way out. Otherwise, we're going to go ahead and remove these chains. The first one is pretty simple. The second one's even simpler, actually. And the third one is a little bit more complicated. This one actually requires the Deluminator Lamp. Again, we're going to need a key character as well. Look at me, I'm trying to jump, but you can't jump with Lumas. That's one weird thing that I'm not sure why that is. If you guys know why that is, drop me a comment down below and tell me. Like, I understand that Lumas is kind of like a flashlight at times. Like, you can see Hermione's holding it up, and it's totally, like, weighing me down. But does the light actually weigh something? Like, what's the reasoning behind that? If any of you guys know, please enlighten me. All right, so we need a key character to go ahead and lower this. And you probably noticed we raised the roof on the other side. Actually, we're going to raise the roof right now. We're going to go ahead and take this over there. And we lowered this side as well. So now we got to raise it up. And once the light is officially in there, check it out. We've got it. We're going to scare them devil snares away. And one last little flip of Leviosa removes the final chain. And it actually takes us to the final area of this level, which is a little confusing at first. You start off controlling this giant dragon. You actually have to toggle back to one of the characters riding on his neck. And then you have to, if you notice, there's actually five character tokens up on the top that look like Griphook. I'm not sure if that's who it is. But really what we need to do is target these little guys that are running around and take out all five of them. Now, you can see I can target them and they run behind the wall, not being accessible to my attacks. So you gotta kinda wait and time it just right. I was finding too that, you know, normally when you target something, you simply target and then let go and it shoots. I was having to target something and then like double tap in order to launch or cast my spell. So a little tip for you, you might have to double tap-a-roo once you've got the aim all secure. So hey, once you get all five of those guys, it takes us to the final totals. That's right, we got the House Crest, all four pieces, and we also got all three of the character tokens, including Griphook. See, look, it looks like Griphook, but it also kind of looks like Bogrod without glasses, so I'm not really sure. But we also got Hermione Gringotts Edition, and of course we got that 100% of the True Wizard requirement, and we're going to go ahead and cash in that stud total, as well as get our gold bricks. And then we'll be off and running, ready to go to the next level. In fact, we're going to try to wrap this up as quickly as possible. Turn that frown upside down, buddy. That's right. I think getting this done is going to make you guys just as happy as that student in peril was when we rescued him. So, ironically, we are two bricks away from the halfway point. And, you know, we get three bricks every level. So you'd think that, oh, we're going to surpass that by one. But as it turns out, we actually already accidentally got the True Wizard requirement in our story for the next level. So we do get two bricks and we end up with 100 after the next one. So I know that was a little bit of a spoiler alert, but you'll find that out soon enough. So, hey, that's going to wrap it up for LEGO Harry Potter years 5-7, level 19, The Thief's Downfall free play. If you guys have any questions, head over to Facebook, Twitter, or simply comment, vote, subscribe down below. And of course, HappyThumbsGaming.com is available for your viewing pleasure as well. Now, as you guys probably know, we have game breaks every month and we do shout outs. And we also do, textual, like visual shout out, like where we actually post your name on the video. And then we also do one where we actually shout out your name. Now, we've been outside lately. I don't know if it'll always be a literal shout out, but that's how it's been. So, check out our game breaks. If you want to get involved with that, head on over to patreon.com/happythumbsgaming, which the link's down below in the video description, and find a tier that works for you. As for me, that's going to do it for now. As always, until next time.